Oh, good morning, Mrs. Burrows.
I'm so sorry I'm late. We had a broken window and I had to wait for the glaziers to come.
No, not at all. I heard about the disturbed night that you had.
Oh?
Yes, the police phoned. You acted very sensibly in bringing them in. Congratulations. Young Clark could make a habit of that sort of thing.
Yes.
Well, according to the police, they didn't catch sight of him, so I imagine he must have thought better of it.
Oh, I'm sure he'll be all right.
Yes, well, one way or another, young people usually seem to work their problems out for themselves. But if you buy into them too deeply, well, you never get any peace at all. That's why the department frowns on any personal involvement. You're employed to give your cases professional help, not take on the responsibility for their entire lives.
Yes, well, I mean, I do try to keep that in mind.
Yes, I'm sure you do. Well, now, have you got those reports ready on Kennedy and Langford?
Oh, no, I'm sorry, I haven't.
Well, they are rather urgent.
Yes, I know, but the last few days they've been really hectic.
You're not letting the work get on top of you, are you? I noticed there were another couple of reports late also.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll be on your desk first thing in the morning.
Right. Just as soon as you can manage. We don't want you driving yourself into the ground, do we?
Anyway, Vera says to Terry, she says, come to bed, darling, it's late. And Terry says, I'm not coming till you bring a brown paper bag. She says, what do you want a brown paper bag for? He said, to put over your head.
You know, there's just got to be somewhere we can use it.
And why don't we blackmail him?
Oh, a little subtlety, if you don't mind. Oh, I'll think of something.
Who cares?
What's wrong with you?
Nothing.
I think she's upset about you letting Margot bash her. She'll get over it.
Yuck, something stinks, and I bet it's not the dirty washing. A rat. A dead rat. Or very soon will be.
Now, I wonder where the pack is.
What pack?
Oh, the rat pack, old Bev and Lil. Oh,
they've deserted the sinking ship.
Shh. Hey.
Do you hear a squeak?
Listen, if you're going to bash me, why don't you just get it over
with? Yeah, I heard that squeak too. You know, one thing upsets my pacemaker. Yeah? It's a rat. You're going to have to do something about it, Bev.
All right, all in our own good time. Like a bolt out of the blues. Hey, Lizzie, how's the book going?
What book?
Well, you know. I told you last night you're taking over as prison bookie.
Oh, right. That book.
Wait a minute. I've always been the bookie.
Don't tell Gaffney, though. We don't want to upset her. I mean, it's not long before, well, you know what I mean.
I didn't mean to startle you. Here. Hope that's the brand you like.
Tough.
Well, how are things? Everything all right?
Yeah. Why shouldn't I be?
Oh, it's just you had a bit of trouble with Smith yesterday.
Why are you so interested? I mean, screws don't worry about us.
I'm just doing my job. As a prison officer, my duty to look after the prisoners. All of them.
Don't seem to be very busy.
Tea break. But I better be getting back.
Yeah, well, thanks again for the rollies. That's real nice of you.
My compliments.
Ah, there you are. How was your day?
Oh, not bad.
Oh, not bad, but not brilliant either. Drink?
Yes, please, I'd love one.
Nick?
Oh, no, thanks. What are you doing?
Oh, just catching up on some reports.
You work quite hard enough, darling, without bringing paperwork home.
I've nearly finished. Tell me, what does a junior clerk do?
Nothing much.
Don't underestimate it. Being a courier is not just hairing around in a car. It's a responsible position.
I'm sure Nick realizes that.
I do. Just hope I don't muck it up.
Well, you won't if you put your mind to it.
Would you like to turn on the telly?
Would that be okay?
If there's nothing else on. Meg works full time, Nick. She could do with a hand around the house.
Oh, sure. What can I do?
Well, you can peel the vegetables for dinner if you like. They're out on the bench in the kitchen.
Okay.
Aren't you overdoing the heavy father bit?
That's what he needs. And I suspect it's what he wants. Somebody who cares enough to tick him off.
Tell me honestly. How did he go today?
Honestly? Very well. He worked hard and he learned quickly.
I'm pleased.
You know, it's early days yet, but there's a possibility that he just might make a go of it.
Hi. Oh,
Terry, why didn't you ring me?
What's the matter? You look fine.
Oh, I can just imagine.
Oh, sorry, look, if it's inconvenient, I'll...
No, come in.
Are you sure now?
Of course.
Well, I thought we'd just have a nice, quiet night in front of television. Oh, sorry, these are for you.
Oh, thank you.
Anything to drink?
Yes, help yourself.
Oh, good stuff.
Sit down.
Oh, fine. Vera, look, I was wondering...
What about?
Well, you know the flat I'm in, the one I'm looking after for friends?
Yes.
Well, they've come home sooner than expected.
Oh, what a shame.
Mm, it's very annoying.
Well, what are you going to do?
Well, that's what I was wondering. Look, do you think I can move in here? Only be for a couple of days until I can find another flat.
Of course.
Are you sure? I don't want to cause any problems.
Yes. You've practically been living here anyway.
Oh, thanks, love. I really appreciate that.
Good Lord, darling, you're all right.
No, I think I've got the flu.
Shouldn't you be in bed then?
I can't. I've got all those reports to return to the office. They should have been there yesterday.
Oh, nonsense. I can wait till tomorrow. You ought to see a doctor.
Can you take me?
Well, I'm flat out. Nick, could you drive Meg to the doctor's? You can take her car, then when you've seen the doctor and brought her back here, you can come on to work, okay?
Sure.
I've got to go now.
Bye.
Take care.
Would you like some coffee, Mrs. Morris?
No.
You know, I really appreciate what you're doing for me. It's like having a real home. Look, why don't you go back to bed? The doctor won't be able to see you till 9, so you might as well sleep till then.
Yes. Yes, I think I will, Nick.
Gaffney, how's tricks?
A lot better after having a good smoke. Thanks again.
Ah, don't mention it. You've picked all the winners, have you?
Well, that'll be the day. You interested in the judges?
Oh, I've been known to have a bet or two. Mind you, I'm not a fanatic.
Nah, neither am I. But that's one of the things you miss being in here. The occasional flutter.
Yeah, I suppose it would be.
I suppose... Oh, it'd be too much trouble for you to put a bet on for me at the TAB, wouldn't it?
Well, it sounds pretty harmless.
Well, the third race at Kyneton. Fancy Nancy and Paradise lost, $2 each way.
Well, sounds like a good bet. I put a dollar on myself.
Sure you can remember?
Oh, I think so. Well, I'll fix it up for you.
Hey, don't you want to know where I got the cash from?
Not particularly.
Oh, there's old Vinegar Tits, one where her other half is.
Yeah. She's just wild about Terry, and Terry's wild about me.
Just get on with your breakfasts.
Huh. What's the point in doing that if she's not going to bite?
Don't let it get you down, Jude. I wonder where Gaffney is. She hasn't had a meal yet.
Too yellow to show her face.
I reckon I know where she is.
Where?
Reckon I know where Harrison is, too.
What are you getting at?